There was a day, I can't really remember name or location, where we had this conversation. As the particles of the golden sun rays struck our faces with such brilliance and warmth, as it was about to put on the blankets of the horizon, the sunset. The birds were retiring for the day with whistles to their nests. The wings of the fireflies and butterflies were both colorful and gray. The distant mangrove was such a sight to behold from that perfect garden. He was in his mid-20s, about 5'7". He broke the silence, said to me, "Sam, I say you're part of that Jesus something, aye?" Taking the rose from my nose, I replied with a smile, "Yes, I am." He continued, "Putting one and two together, truth and false on the payroll, I see no difference between myself and that white dude called Jesus. His death couldn't have paid my debt, for I'm rich and I owe no one. So I don't need any fearful prayer of salvation or for healing." Aside, it'd be like say sickness never catch you where they carry you go hospital, Abby. Or your village people never they turn your pot and you they explain. No evidence. With this righteous anger boiling inside of me, I would have picked up a broom and flogged out the witchcraft he was possessed with as I screamed at the same time, "Who hath bewitched you, oh foolish boy?" Believe me, I would have. But I maintained my calm as a dove, but spoke with the boldness of a lion. I said, "To begin with, Jesus ain't white. You see, that natural with blue eyes and brown ears isn't just a man. He is divine. Please note, not Candy Crush compliments, sweet, delicious, divine. His birth needed no milky-like cell research to crack open the eggs. First, I repeat, his birth needed no milky-like cell research to crack open the eggs. First, for with God, nothing shall be impossible." But he wanted to interrupt. I said, No. I'm not talking about the "come and I'll make you rich" Jesus. We have actually forgotten. He said, "Come and I will make you fishers of men." I'm not talking about the white hair, white robe, red mantle, costume Jesus. I'm talking about the man Jesus that turned H2O into vodka. The chairman tested and testified. I'm not talking about some footballer Jesus. I'm talking about the one who is greater than any goalkeeper that keeps his own safe in the hollow of his palm. I'm not talking about some quick, slow, fast music Jesus that gives emotional satisfaction but do not give you soul life. I'm not talking about some footballer Jesus. No. I'm talking about this same man Jesus that sang an odel in the face of death. For this same man turned death into a siesta and the grave into a spa. He came for the weak and the defenseless. He came for the poor and the young. He came for the good, the bad, and the ugly. I promise you, he came for you. For as many as received him, to him he gave life to become the wills, the sons of God. For God, at sundry times and in diverse manners, has spoken to our fathers, our past lives, our avatars, by the prophet, but has chosen this time to speak to us by Son, the man Jesus. So please do not refuse him if he's speaking to you tonight, if he's asking you to surrender your soul, if he's asking you to do this business for him, not minding what you gain or what you will lose, because in him is life. Rest in peace, fam.